Today, there are thousands and thousands of new fashion crazes placed in front of us all the time. And with these new changes happening, young girls and boys are the main target. And one of these recent fashion crazes that have definitely captured the eyes of girls of all ages everywhere are hair extensions. Hair extensions have boldly made a name for themselves for being practical, ever-changing, and a statement brand that isn't going anywhere quietly. From Beyoncé Knowles to Rihanna to Demi Moore, so many celebrities have paved the way for this trend to be glamorous. But is it because celebrities wear them that this is the reason why girls and women tend to wear them? Or is there a different reason? We as the female generation tend to be drawn in from all different angles on how we should look. This is mainly from what we see and read, be it whatever newspaper or magazine that is out there. There is always an article, tip or opinion about hair that girls tend to take an interest in when reading. Now in the 21st century, there are so many doors opened for us to be creative and different. And this is exactly what the public are doing with hair extensions. Today there are websites, form rooms, organisations that have selling your hair as their selling point. And it doesn't stop there. People can even take it into their own hands to go through social networking sites to build a page and broadcast their hair so people can buy and turn them into their own hair extensions.
It's a really easy thing to do. Anyone who has decently long hair just takes a photo of it and places it on their own website or any other website of their choice. And then it's up to you to advertise how long your hair is and how much you want to sell it for. And then you wait and see if anyone takes an interest in it.
So you see how easy it is to buy and sell your hair at the comfort of your homes. Those in the trade reckon, in this country alone, the hair extension business is worth around £60 million, and the British women spend a stunning £65 million a year on their hair extensions. Talking about the business here in Nottingham City Centre, there are so many salons and shops that sell a huge amount of different styles, types and colours of hair extensions.
These days, you can make a business, buy, sell and make money, and it's right in front of you. Taking something as simple as hair extensions can genuinely make you get by, and this is also another reason why young women find this trend so appealing.
These days, the hair industry has become bigger and bigger. From countries India to Peru, this human hair profession has definitely spread across the whole globe and has seized the UK quickly, making it the third to be the largest carrier of human hair in the entire world. But why do young girls really wear them? What is it about hair extensions that make them so attractive? There are many different opinions and explanations.
Some people look quite stupid wearing hair extensions because they're like different colours to their actual hair.
Yeah. Also, like if they've got really short hair that sticks out at the back, you can see that they are hair extensions. So it's best to like straighten it so you can't see them. Especially when they look more natural, I think.
There you were able to hear what people's thoughts were on hair extensions. What about the positive and negatives? Are they good for us? Is there lasting damage? Or is it all just paranoia?
I think I must have started wearing hair extensions when I was 14 because I cut on my hair off or something and I just didn't want short hair anymore. So that's why I started wearing them. Also, I think another reason why I probably started to wear them is because my older sister did, and I think I probably just wanted to like be like her and copy her.
I've never worn hair extensions before, but it's like, I think the idea of having something in my hair scares me. And like, I just feel like, you know, if they're there, like they might damage your hair, make it worse, and I don't know, someone could just rip them out.
Yeah. Too high maintenance. For one, I used to glue them in, and they'd get like the back of your head would get really sweaty, and like when it came to taking them out, you'd have to put this like solution glue on it and like comb it out, and then the glue would get stuck to the back of your hair, and it was awful. It was really, really painful.
Yeah, I've heard stuff about weaves where the sewing bits gone wrong and the hair just got burnt off and just like got really damaged, but apart from getting damaged, not much.
And you can get, I think I had clip-on ones for a while, but that got too high maintenance because you have to, like, every so often you have to take the hair out, wash it, condition it, treat it, or else it just becomes like a different texture of your actual hair and you can just tell that your extensions are fake. And the strain on that, on the back of my hair, made my hair fall out, so I actually like did get some bald patches from removing the glue that was in my hair.
Well, I think girls who wear hair extensions nowadays, they're like quite fake because they try to be, you know, the Barbie doll image, they try to carry that Barbie doll image that they haven't got. And it's like, don't do it, just embrace your own hair. You've got it. It's better than not having it.
I think it's totally like a personal preference thing. I think some people wear hair extensions because they feel self-conscious about like maybe their hair's thin or like, you know, they've got like thinning hair or something, you can see your scalp. So I think in that case, wearing hair extensions, you know, might make them feel better or whatever. But I also kind of think that some people wear them for the sake of wearing them. It's quite petty, but I think if you're gonna wear extensions, wear them properly. I can't tell you the amount of like girls I've seen with hair extensions and their clips poking out, and it's just like, just put them in properly, just get them done properly. Yeah, I think if, you know, you're self-conscious and some people wear them, other people just wear them for the sake of wearing them because they think that's fashionable or like what girls wear.
So there you can see that hair extensions can be a problem at times too. But what about the benefits? There must be some good aspects to them. With there being both positive and negative sides, the vote is pretty split in the middle. These days you can make to £1,000 to £2,000 on selling your hair. But of course this means what type of hair you have. Untouched, uncoloured hair, commonly known as virgin hair, is considered the number one of all hair types. And people will pay good money to get their hands on this. But would you sell your hair? Is it even a good idea in the first place to get your hands on some extra cash?
Because I've got virgin hair, I would sell it, but it's never got long enough to actually sell. Mm-hmm. Like if it would grow really quickly and I could cut it off and still have a reasonable length of hair, I'd definitely sell it. It's definitely something I've thought about. If girls spend a lot of money on hair extensions, I think it can look quite good. And I know now there's different techniques to putting them in, and it's definitely like got better, but I personally wouldn't do it.
Virgin hair has definitely become the money maker, but not all of us can settle into selling our hair because of how damaged it is. But what about talking about people with bad hair extensions? Is this the reason why people may be put off by them?
Around Nottingham, there is a lot of variety when it comes to hair extensions. The businesses in Nottingham and in other cities for that matter have really extended their range. Not only is it just possible to get one type of hair extensions now, there are so many types and such a selection which makes it so appealing for girls.
Around Nottingham, there are many salons and hair extension shops all over making a name for themselves. And with this fashion statement, the hair extension business in Nottingham alone is getting more popular by the day. From the Victoria Centre Market to the high street salons to side stores to even high street clothing stores, everywhere is starting to get in on selling this product. It is safe to say that Nottingham is starting to become well known for this reason alone. Now time for some myths and facts on hair extensions that you may not have known about. People who say the hair will not grow if they wear hair extensions. This is a myth. And what about those people who believe some hair used to make hair extensions belong to dead persons? This is a myth. Truth is, fair hair extensions are either natural or have been taken from a living or synthetic. Lastly, can hair extensions damage your hair? This is both a myth and a fact. Studies show that if you get your hair extension fitted at a good quality hairdresser, you will have no problem. Meaning that, yes, if worn for too long or worn in the wrong way by someone who hasn't fitted them in properly, then yes, they could be damaged onto your hair. And that's that. All the details you need to know about hair extensions next time you decide to buy some. We never know when this craze will be yesterday's news, but it is still here and it is still extremely popular. I've been Anissa Ahmed with Hear This, Hear That.